Hello my dear students, welcome for today's video lecture of maths. You know, we are dealing with the chapter 6 decimal, and till now in this chapter we have learned the places 10th, 100th and 1000th. 10th means one decimal place, 100th means two decimal places, second decimal place or two decimal places, and 1000th means three decimal places, right? That we have learned in the previous lectures. Today we are going to learn the expanded form of decimal numbers. The expanded form of decimal numbers. You know, we have learned the expanded form of the normal regular numbers. Okay, so like normal numbers, we can find the or we can write the decimal numbers also in the form of expanded form. Okay, so let us learn how to write decimal numbers into expanded form, or when expanded form of decimal numbers are given, how to write it into short form. Okay, so let's learn. Now before learning that, see here, first we will see how we have done the expanded form of our regular numbers. If the number would be 2954, then how we have written its expanded form? Now see, 2 is at thousands place, right? 9 is at hundreds place, 5 is at tens place, 4 is at ones place. So 2000 means either we have written 2000 plus 9090 plus 900 plus 5050 plus 4 ones means 4 in this way, or we have written in this way, 2000 means 2 multiplied by 2 is at 1000 place, so 2 multiplied by 1000, correct? Plus 9 is at 100 place, so 9 multiplied by 100. Plus 5 is at 10th place, so 5 into 10. Plus 4 is at 1's place, so 4 into 1. So this is, or this or this are the expanded form of 2954. Okay, so as this is our normal number, so in this way we can write decimal numbers also in the expanded form. So let's see how to do it. Okay, see here, I'll show you an example. 4.5. See this number, 4.5. Yes, wherever there is decimal point, it is called decimal number. So due to this decimal point, this number is divided into two parts. Okay, the part before decimal point, that is on the left of the decimal point, it is called whole number part. Okay, this, the before decimal point, and part after decimal point on the right, it is called decimal number part. Okay, whole number part and decimal number part. So due to this decimal point, that number is divided into two parts. Okay, the part before decimal point is called whole number part, and part after decimal point is called decimal number part. Okay, so 4.5 means 4 whole and 0.5. understood? Or another example, 245.267. okay, so this, in this, or here only 26 is also okay, in this, which is whole part, this, the part or the number before decimal point on the left of the decimal point, it is called whole number part. And the number after decimal point, this 26, it is called decimal number part. Okay, decimal or fractional part also we can say, decimal number part. Means 245 complete. I ate 245.26 chocolates. Means 245 complete chocolates I ate, or I purchased, not ate, I purchased, okay, 245 complete chocolates, and next chocolate, 246th chocolate, I purchased in part, fraction, that is 26 upon 100 it will be, okay. So this part is decimal number part, and here 245 is the whole number part. Whole number part means our numbers, regular numbers starting with 0, okay, 0 1 2 3, likewise whole, complete. 245 means complete, whole number means complete, okay. And this decimal number means the part which is in fraction, understood? So decimal number has two parts. The number before decimal point is called whole number part, and the number after decimal point is called decimal number part. Understood this? Okay, now this whole number we know how to write into expanded form, whole number, that means our normal numbers, okay. But how to write decimal numbers into expanded form, that we will learn. Now see here, there was 4.5, second number was 245.26. One more example I'll write. 37.628. Okay. Now see, you know, when we saw the expanded form of whole number, here what is whole number? This is whole number, right? So whole numbers places we know. We know the places of whole number. See, before decimal point there is whole number part. The places of whole numbers are ones, tens, hundred, thousand, right? Ones, tens, hundred, thousand, lakh, 10 lakh, and so on. Similarly, after decimal point, what will be the places? To write the expanded form of the given number, we must know if their places, right? So places of whole number, we know that. We have learned 1, 100, 1000, 10,000, lakh, 10 lakh crore, and so on. So similarly, what will be the places of the decimal number? If we know the places, there only we can write it into expanded form. So the first place of decimal number immediately after decimal point is 10. What is that? T-E-N-T-H, 10. Now if remember, we have learned the concept 10th. 10th means, 10th means upon 10, 1 by 10, correct? Means 1 means here it can be any number. Here 1 upon 10 means 10th. Okay. The next place will be 100. What it is? 100th. That is 1 upon 100. And next place will be obviously 1000. That is 1 upon 1000. Okay. See these places and keep it in mind. After decimal point, the first place is 10th. 1 upon 10. Next place is 100th. 1 upon 100. And the next place is 1000. 1 upon 1000. Which will be next place? 10,000. Okay. In this way. So we have to learn only these three places. Here 1 means 1. Here 10. 100 means 100. 1000 means 1000. Okay. Understood? Now whenever we are going to write expanded form of these numbers, 4.5. 4 is the whole number part and 5 is the decimal number part. Where will come 4? This 4 will come here, that is 4 ones, here decimal point. And next place, after decimal point, 5 will come. So 5 is at 10th place, 5 10th. Okay. Similarly, see this, 245.26. First, let's write the decimal point in this column, decimal point. Okay. Which digit will come in the ones place? In the whole number, there is 245. Which digit will come in the ones place? 5, correct? Tens, 4. 4 tens. And 100,
2. And in 10th place, which digit will come? 2. And at 100, 6. Okay. Then, third one. There is, in whole part, there is 37. 37, this is whole part, whole number part. So, in the 1st place, what digit will come? 7. And in the 10th place, 3. There is no 100 and 1000s place. Now, in the 10th place, 6, correct? 100, 100, 200, and 8000. Understood? 8000. Okay, so these are the what we have written these decimal numbers into the place value chart, into the place value chart. Okay, so write this place value chart in your notebook. Understand, keep it in mind this name of the places, because when we are going to find the expanded form, we must know the places. Keep them, visualize them in front of your eyes, okay? 10th means 1 upon 10, 100 means 1 upon 100, 1000 means 1 upon 1000, okay? So, while finding the expanded form, we will need this, okay? Now, pause this video and write this chart in your notebook. Now, let us see how to write the expanded form. Okay, now see, same numbers we will take, 4.5, 4.5, okay. Now what we are going to do, first see this digit 4, 4 is at which place? 1's place, correct? Because it is in whole number. 5 is at which place? First place after decimal point, it is 10th place, TTH. 10th is different and 10th is different, okay. 10th place is the first place immediately after decimal point. So 5 is at 10th place. Now 5, 4 ones. How to write 4 ones? 4 multiplied by 1 plus 5 tenth. How to write 5 tenth? Tenth means what? Upon 10. So whichever number is there at 10th place, write that up and upon 10. So 5 upon 10 means 5 tenth. That means 5 is at 10th place. Okay, similarly see here, first see here, let's see about whole number, 2 is at which place? 1's, 10's, 100. If you are confused, write the places here, 1's, 10's, 100, after decimal point, first place is 10th, then 100th, 100, okay. So now see, 200 means 2 multiplied by 100 plus 4 tens means 4 multiplied by 10 plus 5 ones means 5 multiplied by 1 plus 2 tenth means 2 upon 10 plus 600, 6 upon 100. Understood the difference between 100th and hundredths? 100th means upon 100 and hundredths mean multiply by 100. Okay, get that difference. Next, before decimal point there is 37, that is 7 is at 1's place, 3 is at 10's place, after decimal point 1st place, 6 is at 10th, 100th, 1000th, okay, 1000. So now 3 tens means 3 into 10, 3 multiplied by 10 plus 7 ones means 7 multiplied by 1 plus 6 tenth, okay. So 6 tenth means 6 upon 10 plus 200 means 2 upon 100 plus 8000, 1000th means 8 upon 1000. Understood? So in this way we have to write the expanded form, and sometimes they will give expanded form or expanded form will be given and we have to write into short form. Okay? So we can understand the digits are at which place by this, upon 10, upon 100, upon 1000, or multiply by 10, multiply by 100. we can determine the places of that particular digit. Okay, this need not write, we will directly solve the practice 6.5. See here, practice 6.5. Open your page number 108. Practice 6.5. The first question is, see the first question. See the first question. Express these fractions as decimals. Express these fractions as decimals means they have given expanded form and we have to convert them into decimal form, means short form we can say. Okay, so see the first one. 4 plus 5 upon 10 plus 6 upon 100. Second, 20 plus 2 plus 3 upon 10 plus 7 upon 100. Third, 6 plus 5 upon 100 plus 2 upon 1000. 30 plus 5 plus 6 upon 10 plus 9 upon 1000. Okay, these are the examples in the first question. These are the expanded form. Okay, expanded of form of the decimal numbers. So these expanded form of the decimal numbers you have to convert into decimal numbers, that is short form. Okay, so see now here. See, there is only 4. Only 4 means 4 is at which place? Only 4 means 4 ones is at ones place. Okay, so 4 will come here, point, because after ones place there is point. Then 10th place means upon 10. Which digit is there having upon 10 divided by 10? 5. So 5 will come at 10th place. Okay, then after that there is 100th place. Or better, what we can do here, we can write here ones place, we'll make chart. Okay, here decimal point, ones place, tens place, hundreds place, thousand. Here according to sequence you have to write, according to sequence again, 10th, 100th, 1000. Okay, now see here on the first 4. 4 is at 1's place, correct? 4. Here decimal point. 10th place. 10th means upon 10. Which is there upon 10? 5, correct? 5 will come at 10th place. And 100th. Upon 100, this 6. So 6. That is 4.56. Okay? The next. 20 plus 2 plus 3 upon 10 plus 7 upon 100. Okay, so 20 means 20 means 2 tens, correct? It will come at here. Then 2, 3 ten and 100, 700. Okay, so that is 22.37. Once again I repeat, remember these places. These places should be on your tip of tongue. Okay? 1, 10, 100, 1000, then after decimal point, first place 10th, then 100th, then 1000. Here see 6, only 6 is there, that means 6 ones, okay, decimal point. 500, now see here, see this example, 6 means 6 ones, okay, so we have written 6 in the ones column. 5 upon 100, there is no 10th place, there is no 10th place, means 10th place is not given there. So in that case, what to do? We cannot write 5 here because 5 is 100. 500th, 100th. So 5 should be at 100th place, in the 100th place, okay? And 2 upon 1000 is 2000. So 2 should be at 1000th place. Then what about this 10th? There is not any digit, that means it has 0. So this can be written as 6.052 in this way, okay? Don't forget, if there is 10th place is vacant, if it is missing, absent, then we have to put the 0, okay? Next, 30, 30 means 3 tens, right? So it will come in the tens column. Then 5 ones, 6 tenth, 6 upon 10 means it will come in the 10th place, okay? Now see here, 9 upon 1000, directly 1000 is there, 100th place is missing. What to do? Put 0 and 9 at 1000 place. So the number is 35.609. Okay? Now pause this video, write these 4 examples in your notebook. Okay, let's see the next question, question number 2. See here, question number 2. Write these decimals in expanded form. Now, decimal numbers are given. We have to write it into expanded form. 38.342. 49.761. 395, 290.876. So see these four decimal numbers are given and we have to write them into expanded form. Okay. So see here, 38.342. 8 is at this place, 1. Before decimal place, whole number. So first rightmost place is 1, then tens, and here after decimal point 10th, 100th and 1000. Okay, 1000. So see, 3 tens means 30, or you can write this way also, 3 into 10. Okay, 3 into 10 means 30 obviously, and 8 ones means 8 into 1 plus 3 tenths. 3 tenth means 3 upon 10, correct? Plus 400, 4 upon 100, plus 2000 means 2 upon 1000. Okay? Again, next. This is 1's place, this is 10's place, 10th place, 100th place, and this is 1000th place. So 4 tens means 4 multiplied by 10 plus 9 ones, 9 into 1. Okay, let's come after decimal point. First place 7 tenth, that is 7 upon 10 plus 6 hundredth, that is 6 upon 100 plus 1 thousandth, that is 1 upon 1000. Okay. Again, 64.395. So 4 is at 1's place, 10's place, 10th, 100th, 1000. Okay. So 6 tens, that is 6 into 10, 4 ones, that is 4 into 1, plus 3 tenths, so 3 upon 10, plus 900, that is 9 upon 100 plus 5000, so 5 upon 1000. Got it? Last one. Here, ones, tens, hundreds. O, this is O, not 0, O for ones. 10th, 100th, and 1000. Okay? So see, 200s. 200s means 2 multiplied by 100 plus 9 tens means 9 multiplied by 10 plus 0 ones. Now see, there is 0 ones. So if you write 0 into 1, what answer will be? 0 only. Okay, so if we do not write 0 in the ones place, that is also okay, directly we can write 10th place. Okay, and if you write 0 into 1, that is also okay. Then 8 tenth means 8 upon 10 plus 700, so 7 upon 100. And 6000, so 6 upon 1000. So in this way, we have to write the expanded form of the given decimal numbers. Okay, I hope you understood this, the concept of the expanded form of the decimals. Remember the places before decimal and after decimal point. Okay, before decimal point, as usual, 1, 10, 100, 1000, so on, and after decimal, 10th, 100th, 1000th. Okay, so keep those places in mind, then you can solve this question. You can find the expanded form of the decimal numbers quickly. Okay, so thank you for today and have a nice day.